Hey everybody, it's Linda with Stamping School, working with the Stampin' Up! July through December Holiday Catalog 2021. I'm going to use the Whimsy and Wonder Suite, page 24 and 25. I like it because it has non-traditional holiday colors in it with the pinks and the greens, and it's something a little different than just the red and green that a lot of times we see, which is traditional, nothing wrong with that. But this is just kind of sweet and fun in these little eclectic trees. So I'll show you what the bundle looks like and some of the things that come in the suite. So the suite number is just everything all together, so it's easy ordering, but there's really no price difference, no price break on it. There's always a price break on the bundles, so it's 10% off, but it's just an easy way for everybody to order. So in the suite, you get the stamps and the dies, and then there's this really pretty ribbon that's sort of frayed on the ends like that. It's kind of a nice thick grosgrain. It's a little tricky to tie. It really is something you would use on a bigger present or a bag, but it's great for cards because you can just run it across the seam. So see, it might be a little bulky for a card, but it ties nicely. So that's in the Blushing Bride. The designer paper is specialty because one side has silver foil on it. So you can get an idea of the color palette with a little Moonlight Mist and the Mint Macaron and the pink, right? And then there's a silver foil. There's a lot of glare. All these little presents, which you can cut out and use, which I did for the inside of the card. And this one, Pretty with the Holly, in pinks and greens. And this is actually Mossy Meadow, but to me, it's almost more of a artichoke or olive because it's sort of a little bit lighter. This one is an all over pink and silver foil with a little bit of white. I love that one. And then this one has the trees like that. And the dies cut some of those out, I'll show you that. And then here's the other side. They always do the other side kind of muted so you can use them for backgrounds. Of course, it's hard to cover up the silver side because we all want to use the silver side. Pretty stripes. And this one's just sort of a, can you see it? Just sort of a little all over pattern with some little white wash in there. So also in the suite comes these snowflakes, and I think there's 24 in a package, and they just pop out, and they're like a white iridescent look. I don't know if you can see that on camera, but they're sort of a shiny, pretty white, and on the back, they're matte, so you could color the back side easily. You could color this side. You'd have to use something that, like an alcohol marker or something that will stick to the shiny side. So I just colored the back side with some regular ink. But those are 24 in a package, and those are just really great and easy. No die cutting needed. They're all ready to go. All right, so now let me show you the stamp set and the dies. All right, so the dies will cut this tree and this tree right here. And this one will cut this out. And this little guy will cut these out right here. So I love it when they do that. It's so nice. Here's the stamp set, Whimsical Trees. So a set of 10, and it's rubber. So here's all the stamps, and then you've got also this little polka dot one that can go over and decorate. And you've got little ornaments, which the dies cut out, and the holly, which the die will cut out. Some nice greetings. May the love of the season warm your home and fill your heart, and then joy, and then wishing you Christmas cheer and magical moments that last all year. And two little white trees, which we'll cut out. It's got a little bit of texture on them. We're going to use those today. And then these little squiggle guys, which if you want to use these to cut out solid trees, you can decorate the solid trees like that. And then, of course, a snowy tree, which will go over top of this one. And also some little ornaments. So those come like this, so they cut all at once, which is kind of nice. Little ornaments and little stars, which I think is really sweet. So that's the bundle. Let me show you what we're going to make today. So I started out with this one. I had a request from Tammy, who needs to mail very flat cards. She said they can't have a lot of bumping texture and things like that. So This was my first one I did, and it is a little bit more dimensional. So I ran the ribbon across here and then popped these up with dimensionals. So for Tammy, I decided to do this one, which the trees have a little dimensional on them, but everything else is completely flat. So you could easily just glue the trees down and everything would be completely flat. So it's just a really pretty palette. I just love that pink and the green together. So I'm starting with mint macaron cardstock, and I have a 4x4 piece of that designer paper. That way you get a lot out of a 12x12 sheet. And that just layers in right here. And I did a piece of the 1.5 inch piece of the silver, but I thought, what would it look like with some cork on it? So we've got this great cork paper. It's very thin and it has just a little bit of shine in there. Oh, let's try it and see what it looks like, just for fun. We're gonna cover up that seam anyway. Let's see what that looks like with the cork when we're done, see which one I like better. Now the next thing I added was a little bit of the Blushing Bride, and this is from the Color and Contour die set, but anything works here. I mean, you could do circles, rectangles, squares, ovals, anything works. I just happen to like this die because it comes with these little slits here, which you see me use before to run ribbon through and things like that. So I just kind of like that look to put the banner through to give it a little bit of interest. So we're gonna put that right about there. And then my two little trees, you can put them just flat. Okay, if Tammy needs really flat cards, you can do it that way. Or you can use these little mini dimensionals and just do one of those. You could take one of these little guys and just put one on each. And the little banner is what's going to hold that tail down, because these little guys are almost so tiny to put some glue on. So I'm just going to add these right here and let the banner hold it down. Oops. Bring the smaller one down enough that you can put a little rhinestone or a little star or something up there. And this one up is taller. They're so cute and they're whimsical. And the name of the stamp set's perfect, Whimsical Trees. Now for that banner. So you can do several different things. I tried lots of things. This is, like I said, Mossy Meadow. So I tried Mossy Meadow on the mint, but it's a little dark. It almost looks black. And then I did olive on it, so that looks good. That matches a little bit better. Olive ink that matches that on that. You can also just do white, especially with the cork. When I tried it over here, it was almost too much white, but with the cork, you can actually get away with it and then stamp it in the mint macaron. Or you can emboss it with a little Versamark ink and white powder and heat it, and then you get your embossed greeting. So if you start with a larger piece, I start with 1/2 inch by 5.5 inches, and that way I can use my little, I use the Taylor tag punch all the time for my banner. It's just my go-to, just you can kind of see things a little bit better. But that way you can kind of measure it out and see exactly what fits, and then I just sort of get it with my thumbnail a little bit, and then I can just come in and cut it off. It's easier to me than measuring it exactly and then trying to stamp it exactly, and you know, but that works really well for that. So to attach that, gonna put adhesive across the back of it. You're gonna slide this through, cover that seam a little bit, and that way everything is nice and straight and it's gonna hold the little tree trunks down. Rhinestones work great in a real pinch, or you can use those little stars that come with it, that come with those dies, because you can cut 5 at a time. So those are kind of sweet to put up there. If you can, if it's not too bulky, you can add a few little rhinestones around. Anytime I mail rhinestones, I always put either a piece of a napkin on top, or just a light piece of paper on top before I send them through the mail so they don't get all messed up. All right, let me show you what the inside looks like. So on the inside, you could just do white on the inside, but I wanted to bring that pink in, and I stamped that in the darker ink, which is the Mossy. A little cork on the bottom, couple of the presents I cut out of the paper, and this I cut out with the dies. And that's it. Really fun set. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.